ironic, it's ironic that Phaneuf, every team that he's been on has traded him.
Oh, yeah, of course. Of course. I mean, I've never seen him more useless.
I love it.
Billy, Billy, I'm going to tell you something. When you used to talk like that...
And you know who learned Dion Phaneuf?
Bill, hear me out. What you said, your editorial about Phaneuf with Toronto, you were bang on. And in fact, it was scary how accurate you were when Phaneuf was the captain of the Toronto Maple Leafs and one of his players was knocked unconscious behind the net and he still skated off the ice. If you're a captain, you're going to come and see how your teammate is. I agree. But I believe 100% that while he played with Ottawa, he was extremely relevant and he was a positive catalyst for them.
Yeah.
I can say this. Dion Phaneuf, where he was not, you know, obviously in Toronto, 7 years, $49 million, being the captain, that was way too much. They really fucked that up. No doubt about it. Billy's right.
That was Burke's special.
Yeah, however,
NRI, he does what's best for Brian Burke.
That's right. However, in Ottawa, you know, Frank, I agree with you. He was on the second pairing. He was very well-liked. This year, because Carlson has struggled the way he has, most Senators have said Dion Phaneuf's been their best defenseman this year. But, you know, listen, the team is obviously needing to rid themselves of these contracts. They were able to find a suitor. LA's perfect for Dion because Alicia obviously will be thrilled being out there. Finally, Dion plays for a team that's not a Canadian. This is the first time Dion's played 1,000 games only for Canadian teams. So he finally gets away from, you know, all the Canadian media and the pressures. And I think he'll be okay in L.A. I think that,
he'll play. Nobody will give a shit about him.
Exactly. He'll play on the second pairing.
I've never seen a guy whose star fell that quickly. Remember, it was an Olympic year. He was in McDonald's commercials and Coca-Cola commercials as an Olympian. And they traded him to Toronto, and he bombed.
Listen, John, you were a sportscaster for Toronto. You still are for many, many years.
Yeah.
When you come to Toronto, there's two things that are going to happen. Either the fans are going to take you and love you and bring you to the highest point of your expectation as a superstar in the game of hockey, or they're going to fucking chase you out of town.
And two words for you, Frank. Larry Murphy.
Yeah, well, I got more than that. I can give you more than Larry Murphy. I can give you, what's his name? The can opener, the guy from the New York Islanders.
Brian McCabe out of Toronto.
Yeah.
They chased Phil Kessel out of Toronto. They chased Murphy out of Toronto. They chased the goalie that came from the Boston Bruins out of Toronto.
Ray Kraft,
who was still young, and he was at, you know, as far as his age, he was at the pinnacle of his career. If they love you, like, you know, Gilmore was one of the most hated hockey players here in Toronto when he played for the Calgary Flames and the St. Louis Blues. And he became a superstar.